This tutorial is going to discuss how to modify your wireless DualShock joystick and to make either body armor, DualShock body armor, or DualShock helmet. This is a particular one on a DualShock helmet. You start off by taking apart the joystick and removing the DualShock motors. Very carefully clip them closely to their wire's edge and extend the wires out and through a hole through the front of the joystick. Now you will either drill a hole or you can use a hole that is already there if you happen to be modifying a wired joystick. At any rate, I drilled a hole. I used telephone line wire because it had four wires already running through it, and then four wires is exactly what I needed to come from both of the motor sensors out of the joystick. Now, I soldered my extension wires to my sensor wires coming out of the joystick for maximum conductivity. And then I tape them. You don't want too much wire because you're going to have to get that wire to run inside of the joystick and then come out of the hole using your cabling and still have the joystick be able to reassemble and close completely. Once you've got your wires run, you're going to want to mount your DualShock motors inside of your helmet. I use the ear holes to mount the motors. Just worked out great. I have another design that is a rear mount on the external part of the helmet, which doesn't look as good, but is quieter. Has a DualShock effect, except the DualShock is not left and right DualShock, so it's, you know, both of them are good. I just prefer this design for right now. And once you've got those mounted, you can then run the wires on the inside of the helmet. I taped them down with some what's called Gorilla Tape, which is a very, very powerful duct tape. And you run those wires along the inside of the helmet. Then you can make the proper connections, making sure to pay attention to positive and negative on the motors, because if you get those crossed, it will fry the motors and it will fry the dual sensors in the joystick. So once those connections are made, seal up the superstructure, make sure that there's no connections that are exposed and that can short each other out, and close back the unit and assemble the unit. Install the batteries, and then you should be actually good to go. When you're trying out the unit, make sure everything is turned on, make sure that the remote sensor is properly plugged into the PlayStation, and with any luck, it should work. I used a Logitech PS2 joystick for this experiment. I've also done this experiment on an old PlayStation 1 joystick, so I don't really see any difference. All you're doing is you're mapping the wiring for the motors inside of the joystick to an external superstructure. In this case, it's a football helmet. It could also be set up for body armor or for football pads. The application itself could be expanded to include a full suit of DualShock sensors, which could give you the sensation of being shot in the leg, being hit, fouled on a foul shot on the wrist. There's many applications for this type of gaming technology, and we were already starting to see it in the marketplace, but I hadn't seen this, and I just wanted to put it out there. I've got the first one, and it's pretty awesome. This has been a Kablamo Multimedia Production. I'm Leland Williams of Kablamo Multimedia Productions. Thank you, and appreciate you taking the time to watch this tutorial.